as you have taught us to call the evening, the morning, and the noonday one, and have made the sun to know its going down. Dispel the darkness of our hearts, that by your brightness we may know you to be the true God and eternal light, living and reigning forever and ever. Amen.
O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Psalm 44.
We have heard with our ears, O God, our forefathers have told us the deeds you did in their days, in the days of old. How with your hand you drove the peoples out and planted our forefathers in the land. How you destroyed the nations and made your people flourish. For they did not take the land by the sword, nor did their arm win the victory for them. But your right hand, your arm, and the light of your countenance, because you favor them. You are my King and my God. You command victories for Jacob. Through you we push back our adversaries. Through your name we trampled on those who rose up against us. For I do not rely on my own. And my sword does not give me the victory.
Surely you gave us victory over our adversaries, and put those who hate us to shame.
Every day we gloried in God. And we will praise your name forever.
Nevertheless, you have rejected and humbled us. And do not go forth with our armies.
You have made us fall back before our adversaries. And our enemies have plundered us.
You have made us like sheep to be eaten, and have scattered us among the nations.
You are selling your people for a trifle, and are making no profit on the sale of them.
You have made us the scorn of our neighbors, a mockery and derision to those around us.
You have made us a byword among the nations, a laughingstock among the peoples.
My humiliation is daily before me, and shame has covered my face,
because of the taunts of the mockers and blasphemers.
us of the enemy and avenge us. All this has come upon us. Yet we have not forgotten you, nor have we betrayed your covenant. Our heart never turned back, nor did our footsteps stray from your path, though you thrust us down into a place of misery. And covered us over with deep darkness. If we have forgotten the name of our God, or stretched out our hands to some strange God, will not God find it out? For he knows the secrets of the heart. Indeed, for your sake we are killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Awake, O Lord, why are you sleeping? Arise, do not reject us forever.
Why have you hidden your face and forgotten our affliction and oppression?
We sink down into the dust, and our body cleaves to the ground.
Rise up and help us. And save us for the sake of your steadfast love.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A reading from the first book of the Kings, the 13th chapter, beginning in the first verse. While Jeroboam was standing by the altar to offer incense, a man of God came out of Judah by the word of the Lord to Bethel and proclaimed against the altar by the word of the Lord and said, O altar, altar, thus says the Lord, a son shall be born to the house of David, Josiah by name, and he shall sacrifice on you the priest of the high places who offer incense on you, and human bones shall be burned on you. He gave a sign the same day, saying, this is the sign that the Lord has spoken. The altar shall be torn down, and the ashes that are on it shall be poured out. When the king heard what the man of God cried out against the altar at Bethel, Jeroboam stretched out his hand from the altar, saying, seize him. But the hand that he stretched out against him withered so that he could not draw it back to himself. The altar also was torn down, and the ashes poured out from the altar, according to the sign that the man of God had given by the word of the Lord. The king said to the man of God, entreat now the favor of the Lord your God, and pray for me, so that my hand may be restored to me. So the man of God entreated the Lord, and the king's hand was restored to him, and became as if it was before. Then the king said to the man of God, come home with me and dine, and I will give you a gift. But the man of God said to the king, "If you give me half your kingdom, I will not go in with you, nor will I eat food or drink water in this place. For thus I was commanded by the word of the Lord, 'You shall not eat food or drink water or return by the way you came.'" So he went another way and did not return by the way that he had come to Bethel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Acts of the Apostles, the 13th chapter, beginning at the 44th verse. The next Sabbath, almost the whole city gathered to hear the word of the Lord. But when the Jews saw the crowds, they were filled with jealousy, and, blaspheming, they contradicted what was spoken by Paul. Then both Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly, saying, "It was necessary that the word of God should be spoken first to you, since you rejected it and judge yourselves to be unworthy of eternal life. We are now turning to the Gentiles. For so the Lord has commanded us, saying, 'I have sent you to be a light for the Gentiles, so that you may bring salvation to the ends of the earth.'" When the Gentiles heard this, they were glad and praised the word of the Lord. And as many as had been destined for eternal life became believers. Thus the word of the Lord spread throughout the whole region. But the Jews incited the devout women of high standing and the leading men of the city, and stirred up persecution against Paul and Barnabas, and drove them out of the region. So they shook off the dust of their feet in protest against them, and went to Iconium. and the disciples were filled with joy and with the Holy Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you who now have set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised, for these eyes of mine have seen the Saviour, whom you have prepared for all the world to see, a light to enlighten the nation, and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. And on the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, O Lord, that your angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, O Lord, that we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offences. We entreat you, O Lord, that there may be peace to your church and to the whole world. We entreat you, O Lord, that we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ. We entreat you, O Lord, that we may be bound together by your Holy Spirit in the communion of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. John the Evangelist, and all your saints, entrusting one another and all our life to Christ. We entreat you, O Lord. Lord of all power and might, the author and giver of all good things, graft in our hearts the love of your name, increase in us true religion, nourish us with all goodness, and bring forth in us the fruit of good works. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Most holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments and all just works, give to us your servants that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of our enemies, may live. and quietness, through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Savior. Amen. Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
O God, the life of all who live, the light of the faithful, the strength of those who labour, and the repose of the day, we thank you for the blessings of the day that has passed, and humbly ask for your protection through the coming night. Bring us in safety to the morning hours, through him who died and rose again for us, your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Today, the United States celebrates Labor Day, an official end of the summer, and thanksgiving for the working conditions and benefits achieved by the working man and woman in the 20th century. Almighty God, you have so linked our lives with one another that all we do affects, for good or ill, all other lives. So guide us in the work we do, that we may do it not for self alone, but for the common good. And as we seek a proper return for our own labour, make us mindful of the rightful aspirations of other workers, and arouse our concern for those who have no work. And this through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. Amen. We give thanks for the summer that has passed, for opportunities for rest and recreation with family and friends. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honour and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the Church, and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen.